We're now in our class in Canvas and it's time to get started for the semester. I've tried to make the class as self-explanatory as possible, so even if you didn't watch this video, you would be able to figure out how to get started with the class. So before I actually get started, kind of from a student's perspective, I want to take a look at the homepage and talk about the navigational structure of the homepage. So my Photoshop classes and my InDesign classes use the same template or the same layout. I like it. I think it's good for the intro or the foundational courses. The way that the courses are set up is that there's a horizontal series of buttons and a vertical column of tabs. I call them buttons versus tabs so that if I say go to the modules button, you know to look at the horizontal line of buttons. And if I say go to the announcements tab, you know it's that column on the left-hand side. I feel pretty strongly that you should turn off all the tabs on the left-hand side except for the ones that you absolutely positively need. And so for our class, you'll only see the home, announcement, syllabus, grades, and chat tabs. You will not see the submit final grades tab. That's something an instructor sees. And you won't see any of the tabs that are grayed out when you're in student view. I like that approach because if you get lost, you are not going to click around aimlessly and randomly find an assignment that's due without finding all the pre-work to be able to complete the assignment. I want you to navigate through the class in the way that I've designed it to be navigated and not just seeing that there's something due over here on the right-hand side and submitting it because it's due. Okay. Before we move forward with actually getting started with the course, I am going to click through some of the options that are on this homepage, but go ahead and click through all of them at your leisure. So the Home tab is where all of your coursework starts. It's the home page. There are several paragraphs of information listed here where you can read through them that explain how to get started with the course. There is an Announcements tab, and what I want you to do is the very first thing you do when you log into the course, you should click on the Announcements tab, and you should read any course announcements that have been sent to the class. And I normally don't send 45 announcements every day, but today, the day that I'm recording this video, is the first day of the semester, and so you probably got like 5 messages from me this morning. You should come in here and you should read any of the announcements that have not been read. So you have these little dots over here saying you haven't read this announcement. So you can click on Getting Started in ARC 1200, and it's basically outlining all the things that I'm doing. It's also going to have a copy of these updated intro videos on this announcement as soon as I'm done recording them. I'm not going to read through the announcements, but I do want to point out what they are and why they're important. The Getting Started explains how to get started with the class. I send it out as an announcement because your Canvas course is linked to your email, and so if you haven't logged into the class, you'll still get an email and you should be checking your email. There are a couple extra announcements that probably don't mean a lot to you right now, but as you progress through the semester and it's time to submit work or it's time to use SLCC All Access or it's time to create a color separation, they will make sense to you. And so what I want you to do is just kind of skim through submitting coursework and organizing your files, the Adobe InDesign keyboard shortcuts, PDF, you can download that and print it if you want to, using SLCC All Access and creating color separations. What I would like you to take from it is if in the future you're asked to make a color separation and you can't remember how to do that, you can remember that there's a course announcement that goes in more detail or it reviews how to create that color separation. Everything you have to do in our class is covered in the lecture, and so if you do the lecture thoroughly, then you should be able to make that color separation. But maybe you get to the end of the lecture and you think, I need a little bit of a refresher on that, and I don't want to go find, you know, which video was covered in the lecture. You can come to the announcement and you can read through that. Okay, I'm going to end this second video, and I would like you to read through all the course announcements that are available to you, and when you're done, you can move on to the next video.